Hey folks, Maury here with 316 Automotive. Good morning. Reese and I are here today at Denny's U-Pull in Tulsa. There's Reese right there. We had a client call us that had some, we didn't know the person, but we knew a person, you know, word of mouth in the garage gets jobs and charity jobs. And these folks broke their axle and their lower A-arm in a freak kind of accident thing. And so we're over here at Danny's getting an axle and getting a lower A-arm with the ball joint. And hopefully it's good. It seems we went and looked at all the Chrysler minivans. This is a 06, the client has an 07, so it's the same thing. And this one is the best of the lot, so we're picking this and seeing how well we do. And if it works, it works. These people need a low budget fix, so we're working that out for them and doing the best we can. So, more in a bit. All right, after a lot of fussing and farting, we finally got the axle out. Here's my hat. You can see right there, we got the lower control arm out. The ball joint here is acceptable. The axle is in really good shape. And so for a low budget fix, this is gonna work. Say hello, Reese.
Hello, Reese.
There, man, he is on top of his game. Hey guys, Maury, I'm back again. Hey, I wanted to show you the donor A-arm here. This is the old ball joint that I told you about that I said at Danny's was acceptable. Turns out it was feeling kind of grungy, so I greased it, and it was still, I just didn't feel right about it. I'd need to get another one. So, off the internet, brand new one, and the rest of the kit for it right there. And so I'm going to install the new one here. It's got a snap ring in there, and I'll show you that here. But it's nice and tight and fully greased up, and it's got a opening for a zerk fitting, which is in there. You can see the zerk fitting right there. And so this one here, the zerk fitting, you can't hardly see it in there, it's broke off. And so it was hard to grease, but I got it done. Anyway, I'm going to install the new one here. That just makes me feel better about these people and the repair that we're putting on. So more about that in a bit. All right, folks, we're looking in here to make sure there's no gap around there. There's no gap. There's a beveled edge on the A-arm, and so you know that goes, that the ball joint goes on this side with the flange of it on this side, and we just pressed it in. And so there's a groove right there for the snap ring, so that's gonna go on. Okay, one ball joint greased and installed. So we will get it on the van tomorrow. There we go. Morning, folks. Maury at 316 Automotive. We're at the minivan this morning, and I told you about the job we got to do. You can see the tie rod here is a little bit bent, and we've taken out the busted axle and the the busted up A-arm. So my buddy Patrick there and my buddy Bert, they're here to help us out. And so we're gonna unload and get going. Say hi, guys.
Hey.
Hi, guys.
Hey, there we go.
Great, guys.
All right. So we're gonna film in segments here, and I'll keep you guys informed.
Yeah. All right, folks, we're getting the A-arm in. You gotta lower this cradle here. I call it a cradle. You gotta lower that, and so we removed a bunch of bolts, and you could pry it down, and then you can get the new A-arm with the bushing in there. And now we're working on the front, getting that. There's a little bit of deformed metal around the hole, so it's making it a little bit difficult, but we're gonna have to muscle it in to do that. But we'll get it up. We need a jack, a jack right there. So,
jack,
and that'll just push it up
vertically. So I got the jack right here.
Not wanting to come for some reason.
The bushing's in pretty good.
The bushing can go back a little bit more.
Mark the jack stand up there.
Yeah.
Mark the jack stand.
Hold on one second. Nope. Why don't you lower that down?
Yeah, the teeth. I'm going to get on the jack. I'm close to it.
You're almost there. Keep going. Keep going. Shot again.
Mm-hmm. Hey, that's better.
Okay. All right, now remove the jack.
Remove it.
Yeah. Mm. You can see here. Here's the triad, and
broke.
The other end of it's over there, and so we've got a complete axle assembly from a 2006. And we're stabbing it in right now. Okay.
You like that?
Yeah, you're going to have to, we're going to have to tap it in this way.
Yep, but I got nothing to tap it with, really, as long as you got it lined up.
There we go. All right, that is stabbed in. Oh, hold on a second.
We
need lube on this as well. Put some lube on that. Lube me, baby. You got fingers.
No, but I don't got.
They don't pour it on that rug.
So I'm trying to keep it off the rug.
You're going to be wallowing in it in a minute.
How close over to that ball joint?
Okay, now folks, we've got the tie rod end straightened out. We've got the new A arm in there. New, it's come from a donor vehicle. We got the new ball joint here. We sent Bert to go to the store to wash her up, because when we tightened down the castellated nut here, that's a castellated nut. The hole in the ball joint was up there a little bit. Yeah, I'm sure it's for multiple vehicles. And so what we're going to do is wash it up on the bottom right there, say 3-4 washers, 5 washers maybe. And then that'll put the hole in the ball joint stud right in the middle of that crenellation. And so we'll be, height-wise. And so we'll be good. And Patrick just got done putting some Loctite on those threads right there, because that's what came out. Did you Loctite it real good?
I did.
All right. Because that's what, I call it a king bolt, but it's the forward bolt in the A-arm here. It came out of the vehicle, left the vehicle. We still got to get a wrench on that.
I'm waiting for a wrench.
Will you stop? Folks, this guy here, he is trouble like you can't believe.
Hold it over there.
I guess I don't have to.
All right, we got the washers for the ball joint. So now the hole in the ball joint shaft lines up with the crenellations in the nut. Now I'm just getting it lined up to put the cotter key in there.
I got up to 1 inch right here, Tip. That ain't big
enough. No, I got it. It's a 32.
What?
It's a 32. Okay, I'm going to tighten up. I've got everything tight on this side of the vehicle except for the axle nut. So we're going to get on that right now.
Half inch breaker bar.
Yeah, half inch breaker bar. This is a 32 millimeter nut. I got the washer in there, breaker bar. I'm going to tighten that up. And then we've got the cap. And Patrick, if you could straighten that out for me.
That's a problem. Wish your grandpa's handle. He'd be so proud.
I've got the torque spec on this too. I'm going to go to the truck and get it.
It's going now.
Back on it.
180 foot pounds.
180. I'll tell you what, guys, the all data information on AutoZone, even though I call it all data light, if you know what you're looking for, you can find just about any instruction that you want. And so
180.
I've been pretty darn happy with AutoZone. I didn't even know that they bought all data until just recently.
He-Man.
You know, guys, this morning, I don't like working away from the garage on these projects in the field, because you never know what you're going to run into, and you might not have the right tools. I just prayed to the Lord this morning a couple of times to let this job go well, because we are in the field, and the Lord certainly has delivered. Things are going together better than I had hoped, and I am pretty darn happy. So thank you, Jesus.
I'm happy too. Amen.
I'm happy too.
We almost broke into song right there.
Kumbaya, my.
All right, folks, we just got done with the other side here.
Oh, okay. Yeah, here we are talking to you.
You can see the other nut down there. That the forward A-arm bolt was not tight, and so that was the problem originally. And so we got this one, Loctited it, and got it down real good. So we are ready. We are ready to get out of here. I think we've done this job. So, all right, let's get the wheel on. And you want to go for a test drive? All right, folks, we're back. We're done with the van. The van drives good. He does need an alignment, and we told him that. And so Bert is going to take care of that with his daughter. It's Bert's daughter's van and the son-in-law. So we're back here, and we're going to unload.
Woohoo!
And praise the Lord that everything went well. This is an unusual job in that we went off-site to do it. It's much harder to do that. You got to take all your tools, as you can see there, and it makes it twice as hard to do the job. But we got it done. So. Talk to you later. Until next time, this is Maury with 316 Automotive and Patrick with a lower A-arm right there. Jawbone of an ass. See you, folks.